So, after two days of, I think, inspiring you, I will you now invite to look to the dark side of being a social entrepreneur. I noticed some of you didn't expect this kind of presentation, but I think it's also time to talk about things who are perhaps not so seen by everybody. This is a real situation I faced, you can say 5 years ago. I was 2016 in Madagascar as part of a GIZ delegation, and we was presenting Africa Green Tech to the government, and we show that they can save more than 50% of their energy costs by a switch of diesel and using solar installations. In the evening, we were celebrating because the government was even telling us we can make directly 100 villages. So we go to a German restaurant in Antananarivo, together with the GIZ, and we celebrated, and one of our directors was going to toilet, and he had this situation. He had a pistol in the neck, and they said, okay, you leave tomorrow the country, and because we are running diesel gensets in Madagascar, and we don't want you heavy here. So we come back 21, but this story I tell you later. Coming where we are, you see Africa Green Tech is working in one of the most dangerous zones in the world. We call it the Sahel. It's not only a terror war zone, it's also one of the zones where the causes of climate change are really visible, where people already are fleeing. We have more than 2 million refugees already only in this zone. And the problems will be more difficult in the coming years because, as you know it, even in Germany, we have the problem getting bigger. And in this zone, we are running today more than 20 villages. Some of these you can see. These are the names of the villages. As you see here, on every ring, I also have a name of a village. And each village is more than 5,000 people we electrified. And in this zone, we have this 20 in the last 5 years. But we also have an experience that only with electricity we can't make a profitable business model. And so we created, in the beginning of 2020, the impact site. And we, not only using electricity, we also use cooling, water purification, water irrigation, and internet access as a revenue model. And this is the solution. Our heart, our solar tanner, you can visit outside. It's quite big. Many people told me that they saw it on the videos, and they was expressed that it's so huge. And coming back to 2020, I was in Mali. We made with the Deutsche Welle documentary. And perhaps you remember, it was the beginning of the pandemic situation, and our foreign minister, Mr. Maas, called all Germans back home on 18th of March. So we also get evacuated from Mali on this time. And since October 2019, we planned a crowdfunding campaign. So the pandemic really hit us hard. because we talked to our investors and we asked them, okay, shall we start the campaign? Because all people are thinking, everybody will die, and it's not a good time to start a crowdfunding campaign. But finally, we decided to do it. On 8th of May, we started our equity crowdfunding campaign. Some of you are also investors. Thank you for that, for the trust. And in May, we had really a strange situation in the team, because parts of the team was really afraid. So they left even the company. So our team was getting very small. I think we lost the half of the German team in this time of the start of the pandemic. And the others really worked on this campaign every day, very hard. And if you think it's getting worse, yes, it's getting worse. In Niger, on August 2020, we had a horrible attack on ACTED. ACTED is an NGO, was make probably the same work like Africa Green Tech. They helping people in villages. And Al-Qaeda killed 6 aid workers. And this attack had a really huge impact on our team, because we was working in this area also. And after August 2020, all Germans denied to go again in missions. And if you think this is worst, the worst thing happened on 14th of August. It was the military people overtake the government in Mali. What was so far the biggest fear of our investors. As we started 2016 with our electrification, investors always told me, we are afraid that the government will overtake by military. And I remember I told my wife in the evening, now it's over. Okay, we just took our crowdfunding campaign. We had this horrible attack in Niger, where we also have projects. And now Mali, our home country, is overtaken by the military. And the good news is all 20 villages was running until today. Meanwhile, we have the second coup d'etat in Mali. And all our villages are producing energy. People are paying their electricity. And today it's a proof of concept. Because the biggest fear of the investors happened. And we continue. So the things changed, getting positive end of year 2020. And we get this invitation from Idriss Deby from Chad, the president. He invited us to visit him. And the innovation, we presented the impact side. You see this model, we have it here in the hall. And as he is a military guy, he really loved it. You know, he looked at it, he can play with his armies. And he was very, very happy. And he said, look, you are a cool guy, electrify my country. And I was happy because for me, it was a big challenge. Chad is the country with the smallest electrification rate in the world. Only 4% of people have access to electricity. And then a president give you a key and say, do it. No? So I was quite impressed. We create a great team. We fly with 15 people. The whole Chad is running on diesel. All electricity is made out of diesel gensets. It's, yeah, it was even a flashback. Because in June 2014, I founded Africa Green Tech by having this experience standing on a diesel genset, and now a president give me the key and say, change this. Change diesel to solar. So it was really amazing. We was full of energy, I can say. And end of December, I get an invitation from UNHCR. Remember, Chad is also part of the LAC Chad, where is Boko Haram. And Ida and I, we was back in the hotel in the evening. In the morning, we had seen the president. In the evening, we was in TV. And the chief of operations of UNHCR, he told me, he said, oh, you, this guy from TV, you was not the president. Come with me. I show you the dark side of the chat. So I flew with this little airplane in the middle of Boko Haram. And you see me here. I'm sitting there. And yeah. I was seeing 220,000 people, refugees, living in this condition. And for me, this was one of the most hurtful moments in my life, because I see that's the border of social business. What business you want to do with people who are living in this condition? These women who are living here, they have a child, and Boko Haram killed everybody in their family. And this was really shocking. And for me, with this impression, I flew back to Germany. It was then Christmas time. And in January, we had an offer from a big oil company to invest in Africa Green Tech. And remember that I'm a climate change activist, and having this dream to can invest hundreds of millions in a country like Chad, doing what I want to do, I had this opportunity to take the money from the guys who cause all the problems. And I didn't know what I should do, so I asked you guys. Some of you remember, it was a LinkedIn post, and there I asked, shall we take money from the people who caused the climate change to repair what they destroyed? And 69% say yes. Say, take the money, doing good. And I didn't sleep for more than 1 week. And it was a commentary under this post from the Polarstern founder, who said, if you take this money from these guys, I will not work anymore with you. And so finally we decided to deny. We say, shall, thank you, but no thank you. And some weeks later, they lost their lawsuit against them. And today I'm very happy that I make this decision. February 21, we go back to Chad with the team. You see some people from the team. This was in Sar. It's the south of Chad, a very beautiful city running on diesel. But this city with more than 1 million people has only 4 hours electricity a week. And we traveled with our delegation over there. And all of us get COVID in Sar, in Chad. Yeah? And it was not so nice, but all make it. That's the good news. And coming back to the capital of Chad, in N'Djamena, it was the final part of the election party of Idriss Deby, who wins the elections in Chad. And in 22, he killed this guy. So our contract partner, who gave me the key for electrifying his country, they just killed him. And it was a Saturday. On Saturday evening, we was in a restaurant. On Sunday, people was starting shooting on the streets. And on Monday, we get evacuated from Chad. So this is a really painful time. And coming back to Germany, we had this tremendous success with our crowdfunding campaign, because more than 2,200 investors trust us and finance more than 4.2 million. And we broke all records so far made in crowdfunding. And this is also a very, very positive feeling. And after I felt this thankful investments from this many people, I said, hey, all what I faced in Chad, they killed the president, but we will continue. So we talked in the team. Some of them was also demoralized, because the experience in Chad was quite hard for the team to get evacuated. People are shooting around you. Parents are calling, what is going on? And it was really a hard time again for the team. And some of them are outside. You can ask them. And with this experience of making this success, we decided we continue. Even what happened in Chad, we will continue. And in June, our team installed the pilot project in Senegal, because what we say in the crowdfunding campaign was that we enter 3 new countries. So we started in Mali, in Niger, and we said we will go to Senegal, we will go to Chad, and we will go to Madagascar. And in June, we had this positive experience. Our first pilot project was inaugurated in Diop. And in July 2021, the energy minister of Cameroon called us and said, hey, you are cool guys. I heard what you want to do in Chad. President is not over there. Just come to us. We can also give you some villages. And they invite us to electrify 200 villages. It was online. And we will travel in November to Cameroon to discuss. In August, I traveled to Niger. Some of you perhaps follow a little bit the political situation over there. They elected Bazoum, the guy in the picture behind me, and in a democratic way. So it was a peaceful transition from the former president Issoufou to Bazoum. And the director of the Rural Electrification Ministry invited us to restart our 50 villages project. And it was a quite successful day because we signed a contract that we restart Niger with 50 villages. And yeah, so we are on a good way now, but I want to also show that even if it looks very great, it's hard work. It's sometimes not very easy because psychically you have to, yeah, always restart your own power. And I hope that together with you, we can make it and electrify 3 million people until 2030. Thank you. I have even 4 minutes.